Well, it's time to have a bit of fun and look back at the winners and losers of the week. Jenna Clark is with The Australian and she joins me now. Jenna, great to see you. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Look, we've got to start. You've got a very interesting winner for the week. Who is it?
Look, Danica, as you can tell, look at my hair this evening. I need all of the help I can get.
And no.
I love people on the street that are just offering help. And I know that a lot of people may not understand this, but when journos are doing, live crosses for TV out in the street, it's a pretty scary situation. But check out this beautiful passerby in Darwin who probably needs to be taken to Fashion Week ASAP.
Thank you. All right, I got 10 seconds. Thank you.
Now, that is Georgie Dickinson. She is the Channel 9 reporter up in Darwin. And I just love that beautiful lady coming in and just saying, oh, let me fix it a few times. And then apparently she came back after that cross that Georgie had and fixed it again. So, look, I think a lot of us get scared when people sort of approach us on the street because we do work in the media, but that is just a heart-fulfilling scene to see on the streets of Darwin.
Isn't it just beautiful? And look, you and I both know, being journos, we've been out in some shocking conditions when the hair looks terrible, the makeup looks awful. We just look absolutely shocking. I mean, it's part of the job, yeah. Right? But, you know, gosh, I would love to have a personal secretary of sorts like that wonderful woman who helped Georgie. I think that's absolutely fantastic. A terrific winner of the week there, Jenna.
Indeed.
Well, look, I've got my winner of the week, okay? Now, look, it might be a little bit obvious, but I'm going to go with Taylor Swift. Now, I'm going to make a national confession here. I don't know if this is a brave confession or not. I'm not a fan of Taylor Swift. I've never been a fan. I'm probably a handful of people. There's barely any of us. But,
yeah.
Look, the reason why she is my winner is just how big of a phenomenon she is and the impact that she's, of course, about to have on the Australian economy. We've got some really cool statistics here, the Swift economics, as we're calling it. Mm-hmm. So over 620,000 tickets sold. Her seven-show Eras tour will generate around $35 million. I mean, that's incredible, isn't it? And also, she gets a pretty good pay packet out of this, $5 million per show. But overall, Jenna, a $1 billion boost for the Australian economy. You cannot underestimate how significant this is.
No, it's pretty big. And I guess you and I, both being from the West, we know that the importance of any type of resource that is sunk into the economy, being iron ore. Well, now Taylor Swift is doing it for the East Coast. And even today, where we saw the news come out that Melbourne Airport experienced its biggest influx of traffic since the pandemic, with, I think, 117,000 people passing through the turnstiles today. And then I think 25,000 people were travelling just from Brisbane alone down to Melbourne and Sydney to catch the shows. I think it's just wonderful. And I think the vibe at both the MCG and also out at Olympic Park in Sydney when she touches down later next week is just going to be so special. So I think, you know, I think the Swiftie sort of gene will be teased out in all of us.
I completely agree. She's actually on track, I was reading, to become the top grossing artist of all time. And wow. To put it into context for our viewers, $1.83 billion last year. That's US dollars on sales such as royalties, merch, concert and movies tickets. And if we compare that to Elton John's farewell tour, his was $939 million. Wow. So her Eras tour really is the biggest of all time. I think it's honestly incredible. Yeah, we're both from WA. She's not going to WA. No wonder nobody can get tickets over here in the East Coast. But still, I mean, it would be beautiful to see, no doubt. Jenna, let's move on, because your loser this week is a WA MP who is obsessed with self-promotion.
Yeah, look, when you're a backbencher, you need to do everything you can to get either your constituents to like you or the media. Terry Healy, who is an MP from the Southern River area in Perth. Now, this is what happens if viewers are unaware. In 2021, the West Australian election was a complete wipeout. We only now have two opposition MPs in the lower house in WA. So Labor backbenchers have got a lot of time on their hands because, of course, all of those cabinet ministers are busy with big portfolios. So on the first day of Parliament for WA this week, he decided to stand up and use his very precious minutes on his feet, where he has the attention of the Speaker and the entire house, to not talk about what he can do for his constituents, considering there's, you know, a health crisis in WA. They want to talk about cost of living. They want to talk about the fact that the education system's pretty cooked. No, no, he decided to stand up and just encourage people to like his Facebook account. And if they did so, they'd get some free merch, some Bluey and Bunnings merch, because apparently it's sold out over there. So he's spruiking free gnomes, the Hammer Bar gnomes, which apparently are going for about $100 on eBay and things like that, but only if you like his Facebook account. I mean, it's pretty shameless. I don't know what Zuckerberg would think about it, but I think if this is the calibre of backbencher in Western Australia, heaven forbid the great state of WA moving forward.